Alright, Grath, Dave, here we go. All four rounds. Watching UFC over here. Got Wingstop down here. I get to see all my reactions.
Gentlemen, my name is John McCarthy, and I am just so happy to welcome you to our coverage of this event on the TGC Network. And this is the first round of the event, and we are ready to go. Let's get down to that first tee. And there we go. Got those first drive nerves out of the system. Should be interesting. I think he'll be happy with that. And I doubt he'll be too pleased with that.
The hell? That's weird.
And this pot is for birdie.
Great. I don't like seeing myself in the corner while I'm playing. It's fucking weird.
And starting the round off with a par, not bad. And now let's move to the second hole. Wow, and just a fantastic drive, hitting the green in one. So close. And about 5 feet from the cup.
Oh my God.
That was so, so close.
It's the cameraman. I'm nervous. You see everything.
And after that hole, he will remain at even par. And next up is a par four, folks.
Man, I'm gonna get used to this.
It's looking like it's heading into the fairway.
Oh, this must be a male.
5 yards out. That looks like a 5 iron, and this is looking a bit long, I think.
Stick.
Well, the approach did find the green, but quite a long distance putt ahead.
Of course. Come on, Bill.
Ooh, and it just misses. This one's for par. And our leader is currently sitting at 12 under par. And now the fourth hole. And here's an 8 iron. For the green. And with that, he is on the dance floor. From here, about 11 feet to the cup.
Stay up.
Ooh, and just inches away. And this for the par. And that putt drops. And after that one, he's unfortunately going to be moving down in the standings. Okay, let's see what the fifth has in store for us. And about $125 away.
Left.
Oh. And he is on. And 11 feet to go here.
Dude.
Just misses. And for the par.
Eagle putt and 2 birdie putts so far. 400.
And he's going to stay right where he is, even par after that one. And moving on to the sixth here. From 130 yards.
Come down.
And he will like that. And this putt is for birdie.
Come on.
Ooh, that looked good. This one looks about 4 feet. And that par putt will drop. And after that one, he has gone down in the standings. And he's not going to like that. And let's see what the seventh hole has in store today. I think you'll like that. From 130 yards out. The pitching wedge. And pitching wedge proving to be a bit too much club. And that will not be on the green. Too much club, I think. And to save par. And finishing this hole out with a solid putt. And he's going to stay par after that hole. And now the eighth hole. Going with the 8-iron.
Hit that hill. Come on down.
And with that, he's on the green. And about 11 feet to go here. Ooh, unfortunate. This putt's looking to be about 2 feet. And as we look at the big board, our current leader sitting at 17 under. And now setting up for this par 5.
Behind the wind for me. Excuse me. The hell am I seeing that for?
Oh, I'm not too sure about this one.
Go!
And this one's still in the rough, but it was hit out of some really deep rough into some not so deep rough. And I don't think that was the cleanest of swings. And this is for birdie.
Stay up. Come on.
This one's about 2 feet from the cup. And after that hole, he will stay at even par. And let's see what the 10th has in store. Something seemed off with his swing on that.
Crushed it. Jeez. Stay left.
Maybe not. This one's a toss up. Let's see where this one will land. Close. 5 feet to go here. And that drops for bogey. And after that, one over the day. And moving on to the 11th hole. Appears to be heading for the fairway here. And pretty sure he's going to like that.
See, I did it again. What the f? That cuts me off from a shot.
The birdie.
Stay up. Now come on down.
Oh my goodness, that was close. Yes, about 3 feet to the cup from here. And that putt will go for par. And he's moving on up on the leaderboard after that hole. And now we find ourselves in the 12th. Pitching wedge here.
See,
this might be a bit too much club.
Like fast.
And that shot will be on the green with a fairly lengthy
like
putt ahead.
Up, there you go. Good line.
This putt is for par. And plus one on the day after that hole. And setting up for the par five hole.
Thank you. Sorry.
This is looking fairway bound. I don't think he really had a clean swing on that one.
Yikes.
With 12 feet to go to get to that cup. Oh, that's bad luck. And for the par. And one over for the day. Now the 14th hole. And this one could be in the rough, but could not be. Let's find out. Nothing wrong with that. And this putt's for birdie.
Tap off the amazing iPhone 11 on AT&T, America's fastest network for iPhone. Second tip, skip a googly eyes on your staff to keep yourself company.
Nope.
For example, Seattle
Toronto, my best friend. That was that was very close. This one's about 2 feet from the cup.
iPhone 11 for half off on AT&T, America's fastest network for iPhone.
And as we look at the leaderboard, current leader sitting at 18 under.
Cover that. There you go.
And I think he's going to like that from 115 yards out. And I think he's gonna like that. From here, 37 feet to the cup. And this putt's for par. And a nice putt. And unfortunately, he's going to move down in the standings after that one. For us as a par three, let's see what happens. And about 17 feet to the cup. Nice little putt. And plus one on the day.
Okay, these holes are going to go by pretty slow.
And now setting up for the par 4 tee off.
Just kidding. Wish I was kidding.
Andrade with us here in Vegas tonight. Joe, it's interesting you mentioned Evan Dunham taking 2 years off in his mid-30s at a time where that could be beneficial. He's also dropping 5 pounds tonight. Perennial lightweight threat.
Well, this one's looking like it's in the fairway.
Yeah, very interesting to see it goes up the lightweight.
And about 155 yards out.
Big body kick to start things off. And it was Evan with a strong left hand. He might have hurt her with there.
Burns in the yellow, Dunham gets in the blue. Burns representing Sanford MMA in South Florida.
You gotta remember, you're talking about a guy in Evan Dunham that's been fighting for a long time. Tremendous experience advantage. He has been in there with elite fighters for a long time. Normally, when you watch Herbert Burns, he can telegraph his takedown. Last fight, he didn't have to do that. He was comfortable, but already, Dunham has made him a little uncomfortable, so he's been forced to take out. Now he's got his back. Beautiful job. Taking the back. Oh, wow. He's got the hook. That's a high-level grappling. That's the body triangle. It's on the best side for Dunham, if there is a best side against the guy, and that's this type of grappling.
Because of the fact that he's on the side where the triangle is not.
Everything's going left iron here.
Oh, my God.
You know, guys are getting better at dealing with that pressure.
And missing the approach on that one. Too much club.
But Herbert is a very high-level jiu-jitsu guy. Look at that. Yep, he got it. Oh, 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 my goodness. Did you see him rotate him over to the opposite side? And as he rotated him, he threw the choke in. I mean, that was an amazing finish by Herbert Burns. It was so smooth, and Evan Dunham just couldn't do anything about it. Because Evan's thinking about the rotation, the turn, and as he turned it, he gets the choke in there. It was crazy. It looks like Herbert hurt himself.
Yeah,
something was injured along the way. Right here, you see Herbert
Burns. And this putt could save par.
That's like all the way across through. That trips Evan right back into his lap. He goes right to the body triangle, and from here, he's
solid putt.
Now, I talked about it being on the right side.
And as we check the leaderboard, our current leader is sitting at 18 under par. And moving on to the 18th hole. Wilson was looking pretty good. And this next shot, sitting up below the hole. I think this one might be in the rough. Yeah, that's not very good as far as approach shots go. Just not enough club on that one.
Right
about 6 feet away. And that one's gonna go for Pat.
Should have what? Plus four, that's fine.
Event here on the TGC network. Second round action here, folks. We are ready to go. I hope you are too. Let's get down to that first tee. I don't think we'll find some fairway here. Putts for birdie.
I'm not hearing him at all.
Oh, that's goodness, one. That's almost in.
Sorry, Herbert, we got a bit of
this putt's about a two-footer here.
And my head says they're going to work this out.
And starting today's round off at Haven Park. Setting up for the next par 4 hole. Well, this one's a close call. This could be in the rough. That good, that makes birdie that much more possible.
Oh my.
Inches away. And for the par.
Same fucking putt, look at that.
Oh my gracious, that was close. And this one's for the bogey. And now we're gonna take a look at the leaderboard. And after that hole, one over for the day.
Second here.
See what this third hole has in store.
In a big way, those Burns brothers certainly have a good feel for those arteries, it can be said, and pretty good command of the English language as well. We will see later tonight if his fellow Brazilian Amanda Nunes can do her part and continue to play midnight. She was certainly happy sitting home back in February when a number one featherweight contender emerged.
Hitting bombs straight now all of a sudden.
And he's setting this one up deep in the rough. Well, this one's still in the rough, but that was hit from quite an awkward lie. +2 for the day. All right, here's the fourth hole. On the green, but quite lengthy putt ahead.
She has been on a tear and showing everybody just how great this woman is and getting better with every single fight.
Oh. And that was very close. And this putt's right around 2 feet. Off on this par 4.
And the best wrestlers in the world, the best grapplers, the best judo practitioners, and she's always come out on top, so this is another opportunity for Amanda to prove that she's better anywhere, at any weight class.
This one's looking pretty good so far. This is about a 105-yard shot to the pin.
And by the way, she's just as good a human being as she is a fighter, as we show you most wins in the UFC.
and I think you'll like that. All right, from 24 feet out. This putt's about a two-footer.
Watch that growth. And where she's at right now is the top of the game. One of the things that's intriguing about this fight,
and two over for the day after that hole.
So many high-level fighters. She's fought Misha Tate, she's fought Ronda Rousey, Chris Cyber, all these big names from Jermaine around to be multiple-time world Muay Thai champion. There is a danger. The danger is you don't get up for a particular opponent. Felicia Spencer is not someone that everybody's been clamoring for her to fight.
Teeing off on this par four. About 130 yards to go here.
I don't feel as though Amanda is that type of fighter, but if there is a time, it's usually when you used to get up for Holly or Ronda Rousey, we state, and then you fight Chris Cyborg, and then you fight Jermaine Durantley, and now it's Spencer, like Joe said, someone that's not as well known.
The shot's looking pretty good. And this putt is for birdie. And finishing this one with a big putt. And plus one on the day after that hole. Okay, let's see what the seventh has in store.
Somebody's watching.
And something sounded off with that swing.
Got nervous. Got a crowd.
As a caricature artist, I appreciate what makes each person unique. That's why I like Liberty Mutual. They get that no two people are alike. You customize your car insurance so you only pay for what you need. Almost done.
And this is right around the 8 foot mark. And the par putt drops. And one over for the day after that hole. And now getting ready to tee off on this par three. Approach is on the green, quite a long putt ahead.
I put it through the break.
I thought that one was going to be in. And for the par. And a decent little putt there. And that performance is going to go down in the standings. And on to the ninth hole. And it's looking like this is bound for the short stuff.
Common side effects include injections and reactions and constipation. It doesn't matter what age they bring.
our nation and for all its people.
Looks good. Stick.
And about 4 feet from the cup.
Come on.
And that one will go for 30. And he's going to go down to even par after that hole. And the wind definitely could be a factor on this one. Let's see how this tee shot goes. See that every day. We are on the green, off the tee on a par four.
Ooh.
And this for the birdie. And one under for the day after that hole. And now teeing off on the par 5.
That's right. Self-destructing for a second there.
What a promising looking shot here. And about 17 feet to the cup.
Very close.
Oh.
Yeah, absolutely. He actually.
And this for the par. And a decent putt. And after that hole, one under for the day. And moving along, now on the 12th hole. Like a 7-iron.
Be the club. Be the club.
And he's got to be happy with that. And this for the birdie. Ooh, that would have been good. This putt's looking to be about 2 feet. After that hole, one under for the day. All right, let's see what happens on the 13th hole here.
Oh, I'm trying to look for that fit. Oh,
it is fading.
Sir.
And he's probably going to like that. And it looks like it's going into the deep stuff.
I'm going to destroy him, and this performance is what's going to push me into
One's about 3 feet away. And after that hole, he's going to go up to even par. And setting up now on the 14th hole. Sure, this is going to land in the fairway here. And I think he will like that. And this putt is for birdie. Stay right where he is, even par after that hole. And moving on to the 15th here.
The veteran Mark Smith draws the assignment here at 205 pounds. The beautiful Brooklyn Wren is with us tonight. And this should be a good one. Alonzo Benfield entrenched as the minus 230 favorite. Take it on that man. Brown Bear Devin Clark, the plus 49.
And this drive could go on for days, folks. This is some serious power.
Oh, he fucked him up. Oh, god damn.
After that, seminal land by Benefield. battlefield a moment ago. Oh, look at that damage.
Yep, it's already damaged. It's still hurting.
What are you shooting for?
Has found the green, but there will be a lot of work to do to sink the next putt. Drop for birdie. And he is moving up on the leaderboard.
Hit him in the middle, dude. Like, why do you keep running down the fence?
That's not going to be on anyone's highlight reel, I don't think. And since he's been hitting those greens pretty regularly today, he's probably not going to feel too bad about that. Save par. This one's about 6 feet away.
It's fucking gassed already.
Let's follow Devin Clark back into that blue corner.
And that will be for bogey. And after that hole, he will go up to even par. And let's see what the 17th has in store. Looks like he's going through the branches here on this one. Probably not that happy about that one.
Catches Manafield in a very uncomfortable situation. Very unusual for him to be on the receiving end.
So Alonzo Manafield seeing a second round for the first time since his fourth professional fight. Only three times has he fought into a second round. And he's never needed a third round.
That shot sounded a little off. To save par. And the putt will drop. And after that one, he'll stay at even par. Teeing it up here on the 18th.
There is a definite aggression to Devin Clark here tonight that we haven't necessarily necessarily seen throughout his UFC career.
John, this is absolutely different approach for Devin Clark in the stand-up. Well, he's fighting for his life.
Phenomenal power on that one. See how this one goes. They're setting up below the hole.
Referee called for him to work.
Knee to the body for Devin Clark. This is now the longest pro fight of Alonzo Menafield's career.
And going with the 7-iron on this one. And not the best approach shot.
Oh no.
Setting up here for a 37-foot putt. And this putt is for bogey. Finishing this hole with a solid putt. Gentlemen, I hope you're ready for some golf because it's almost guaranteed to be a good time here on the TGC Network. And ladies and gentlemen, this is the third round of this event. Going right down to the first hole to pick up on the action. This one's going to find the short grass. And he can't be too happy with that shot.
Or any two or more mix and match items for just $5.99 each. So that's something else to be glad about.
Wow, that was nice. And that is going to make Birdie a whole lot easier.
There it is.
For the birdie. And starting today's round off at one under par. And now setting up for the par four. Can't see him being too pleased about that. Well, you'll probably like that. And about 7 feet to go here. Oh, and it just didn't. Yeah. And this for the par. And that one will drop. And he's going to move up in the standings after that break. And I think he will be fairly pleased with himself after that. Third hole has its score. He's probably not too pleased with himself after that one.
And honestly, in this fight, this was the best fight of his career. Look at Devin in his corner. All paying homage to everything that's going on in the world right now. Big for Devin Clark, big victory.
And the shot he's taken through the branches. Putt is essential to save par. Almost, almost. And this one's about 4 feet from the cup. And that'll be for bogey. And that's going to put him up to even par. And now we find ourselves at the fourth hole tee off. Pitching wedge. Well, I think he's going to like that. And 35 feet to go.
Excuse me.
And this putt is for par. And that one will drop. After that hole, he will stay at even par. And teeing off on this next hole, the wind could come into play. Let's find out.
For this one at 125, and it's coming up next for an afternoon.
Okay, this one's looking pretty good. And from 135 away. Well, this one's debatable. Could be rough, could be fairway.
Wow. Are you kidding me?
From 18 feet away. That was very close. And this putt is for bogey.
Good job.
And now let's take a look at the leaderboard. And plus one on the day after that hole. And moving on to the sixth. And there was some serious power involved in this one. Okay, and about 145 yards left.
Before the UFC opened its flyweight division, Alex Perez and Juicy A. Formiga struck up a friendship on the regional scene in California. Now, years later, both fighters racing up the 125-pound ladder, it'll be all business when the two face off here tonight.
Taking a shot with the pitching wedge, and that didn't sound like the cleanest of contact. And ladies and gentlemen, that was a poor approach. I think he tried to fade that one in there, but just didn't pan out. And about 10 feet to go here. And just missing. And this putt is for bogey. And currently sitting at 2 over for the day. And now we find ourselves on the 7th hole tee off. This one's going to find the fairway. About 100 yards to the pin. And I think he will be happy with that. And this one's for birdie.
Up!
Ooh, that one's, that's too bad. And this one's about 3 feet from the cup.
Oh my.
Currently sitting at plus two for the day. Okay, we find ourselves now on the 8th hole tee off. Looks like a 7 iron, and I don't think this is going to end well, folks. No, that's not what you want for your approach. I'm pretty sure the wind was the culprit there. Ooh, it looked close. Just didn't go. And this puts about 3 feet away. And unfortunately, he's going to move down 3 spots on the leaderboard after that. Okay, and on to the 9th. And nicely done, looking like we'll have some fairway here. Putts for birdie. And he's going to move up 2 places on the leaderboard after that hole. One's looking like it's finding the fairway. It's about 20 feet away. After that one, 2 over for the day. Okay, now moving on to the 11th.
Oh no.
It sounds like he's going through the branches here. Sure, he's gonna like that one.
Significant swelling on that left leg, and it's money on it now.
Perfectly timed and placed left hand to the body he struck for me a moment ago.
And if you remember to Benavidez fighting it for me, a lot of kicks to the leg. Really worked his way from the bottom all the way to the top in order to get the finish. Now showing us the hands now to set up that low kick. Obviously a big part of the strategy coming into this fight was attack that left leg. Vega got out of the way of that one.
Perez, the former Selma High School wrestling coach out there in California. Do you see any of that out of the way?
I mean, yeah, man. You know, he was bragging about Selma the other day, but that Selma time's about up for a little bit.
This one's about a 7-footer.
There it is again.
And the power putt will drop.
Oh my goodness, over
and left. After that one, sitting at 2 over for the day.
On that leg.
Oh, and Perez goes right back to the well.
Oh man, it's so busted up. Look at that left leg. That's a mess. Oh my goodness. Oh, that's
a
mess. Wow.
A knockout to the calf kicks. That's incredible.
Two UFCs in a row. I mean, yep, two leg kick victories in a row. One last week it was the kid's top model.
See what the 12 has in store. Going with the pitching wedge here.
Anything right?
Why not?
I think he'll like that. This putt is needed to save par.
That much left.
What am I inches away from greatness. This putt's about 3 feet away. And after that hole, plus 3 on the day. And now, the 13th hole. So far, so good for this one.
Wow.
And it appears it actually ended up in the well.
You have got to be kidding with that kick.
Well, that one was hit out of some very, very deep stuff into some not as deep stuff.
Roll.
I think you'll like that. And this one's for birdie. Oh, and just doesn't want to turn. And now let's take a look at the leaderboard. We're currently sitting at plus 3 for the day after that hole. And next up is a par 4, folks.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't get much better. When you're in a division that starts to sort out challengers, and you see big time performances, Alex Perez shows that he is not only but he's finishing fights now at the highest level. He just put the number 4 contender in the winner's out in the very first round. This is massive.
from 25 feet.
Perez is 24th professional win, you see, and we're going to take a look back at his legwork in this one.
I mean, right here, you see him landing some nice punches with the hands, but it was the leg kick
that
got the job
done. Just missing
right here.
This one was short from the cup. And currently sitting at +3 for the day after that hole. Yeah, setting up now on the 15th. And this is not looking promising.
Yo.
And to save Park. And he's moving in the right direction, moving up on the leaderboard after that hole. And now setting up on the 16th tee.
Beat club.
And this one's heading towards the green. And with that, he's on the green. And this one's for birdie.
This for you guys, man. This for the town. Hopefully I can bring some cheer to you guys, your guys' family. This all for you guys.
And finishing the hole with a solid putt. And he's going to move up on the leaderboard after that one. And now setting up for the par 4 tee off.
So Alex Perez continuing with that belt motion, and why not? He came in tonight with the number 9 next to his name. We show you the flyweight rankings. Figueredo and Benavidez now being asked for the vacant flyweight title. But Perez, number 9.
And this shot's looking promising. And from 155 yards out. Going to the iron here.
Too much.
I think he's overcompensated here. He's flying the green, I think. Well, not a good approach shot there. Bit too much club on that. And this is to save par. Yeah, that one's right in the cup. And currently sitting at 2 over for the day. Now teeing up for the final hole of the round. It appears to be heading for the fairway here. And from 160 yards out. Here's an 8-iron.
Beat a club. Beat a club. Get going. Get going.
All right, and now he's on. This one's right around 8 feet.
Right.
Oh my goodness, close, very close. But once again. And they'll tap it in and end the round with a par.
fighters in the division, including the UFC series. Now, Sun Tao has an opportunity to reestablish himself as one of the top contenders in this incredibly stacked Shark Tank of a division.
So, with Sun Tao and Garbrandt will collide later tonight in the co-main event on pay-per-view. Also on pay-per-view tonight, the welterweight division. Pretty good matchmaking here. I'm excited to see how this one plays out stylistically. UFC star number 22. Neil Mackey against Anthony Rocco.
Yeah, man, Neil Mackey has been around for a long time, and
Sheesh.
Shit,
in the bantamweight division, but if Cody is on his game, there aren't many guys that can really go with him. I just
life. Don't deny the power. Don't deny the influence from his mentors. You see there, Dante Medeiros, the UFC veteran, Matomo in search of his first UFC win here tonight. And now we make way for Charles Byrd as he gets ready for his fourth UFC appearance here tonight. No shame in going down to Edmund Chamas and Joe Rogan, but Charles Byrd has had a lot of developmental time since his last appearance. We'll see how he spends it.
Lock me on top in the grappling. Not only
talk so much about calling fights without a crowd, but when we were in Australia last October, the AC for UFC 243, it's almost said it kind of faced him a little bit. The floor was vibrating, the crowd kind of got his head a little bit.
He said he thought that it wouldn't matter to him, but then he fought for 60,000 people. I don't know how you win that when you're fighting in your UFC debut. 60,000 people won't affect him. Oscar learned that, but today he probably fights in the environment that he probably expected his UFC debut. Great reversal by Bird.
Yeah, Maki almost had his match, but Bird got out of it. Bird on top now.
Nice job by Bird, reaching over the top, taking an underhook.
Put a lot of pressure on Maki's neck here.
Trying to really control the posture of Maki Kudo.
It also makes it real difficult to block him.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is John McCarthy, and we are about to play some golf here on the TGC Network. Well, this is it, folks. Final round of this event, and we couldn't be more pleased to have you with us. Let's get down to the first tee and see how things start up here.
Jesus, my grass like fucking pulling teeth, man. Just take one.
Looking like it's heading into the fairway.
Traditional martial arts technique. Very good front leg kicks. Very good at movement. That's it.
From 245 yards out. Going with the 3-wood. Oh, this is a close one. It could end up in the fairway.
Ooh-wee.
fantastic work on this par 5, hitting the green in 2. This putt's about a 2-footer here. And now let's see what the second hole has in store.
Left, bounce left, one time. Thank you.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is a feat to accomplish. Hitting the green off the tee on this par 4. Oh, that was close. And this putt's for birdie. Come into play on this one. I know some others have had some issues. Let's see how this tee shot goes. Now this one's looking pretty good. Now let's see what happens here. Setting up above the hole. I think this might be a bit long. Well, looks like that one will play on the green. And this putt is for birdie. Oh my goodness. And they're about 3 feet away here. And currently sitting at 2 under for the day.
Thank you.
fourth hole.
Misses on 73% of Kelleher's attempts in round one. Outlanded Brian 29-14 on a mission.
Just this beautiful fancy impression by Cody Stamens was really just, there was a nice right hand there by Kelleher. There's a shot by Kelleher. I would say that it was the beautiful fainting and the pressure that was the story of round one. It's such an unpredictable pressure. Very, very difficult for Brian Kelleher to get the timing down.
I like that takedown attempt by Kelleher for the reason that it gives Damon a little something different than people.
And nothing wrong with that shot. And this is for birdie.
Well, right after tonight's main event, don't miss a recap of all the action on the UFC 250 post show live on ESPN Plus. DC, Megan, and I break it all down for you right after the title fight. It's only on Plus.
And for the par. And after that one, two under for the day.
And he needs a full 8 weeks, a methodical 8 weeks to land on 136. So perhaps the future will be a better one.
Okay, let's see what the fifth has in store today. Connected cleanly with that one.
Beautiful uppercut by Kelleher. And a left hook by Stamen. Stamen goes to the body into the head. That's why he's heating up.
Good throw at the finish.
Wow. And we really haven't seen Cody Stamen fight like this. This is what he said, John. He was worried about winning fights. He looks like more now. He's trying to take a finishing approach. Yeah, we just noticed the rock just showed
and
up.
And this for the birdie. Setting up 13 feet from the cup here. Ooh, and that was very, very close. And this one for bogey. And after that, he's going to move down two spots on the leaderboard. Setting up for the next par four hole.
Inside control, land shots in space eight. Always keep the hip of Kelleher covered, not allow him to get to the outside.
Well, this one's looking like it's in the fairway. And about 100 yards to the pin from here. Looks like this is going a bit long. And I think he will like that. And about 13 feet away here. Ooh, and that was very close. Just didn't drop. And for the par. And finishing the hole with a solid putt. And after that hole, he is moving up on the leaderboard. And teeing off on this par four.
got to be pleased with that.
And from 150 yards. Here's a 9-iron. And I think he will be pleased with that.
Come on down. Get in there. Oh, come on.
Very nicely done. Long putt right into the cup. And setting up for the par 3 hole. One.
Oh, there's a hill there.
Not just good rocket,
oh, here it comes.
And I think he'll like that. This one's about 9 feet away.
Well, like John said, he evaded 80% of the strike thrown at him on number one. That's a crazy high stat.
Oh, my land. That was very close. This looks like around a 4-footer, I'd say. That putt will drop for putt. And sitting at 2-under-4 of the day. And now the 9th hole. Promising looking shot here.
And the trajectory that he was on. And honestly, he's very aware of where he stands today because he said he just wasn't ready for that level at the time. But now he can go back to getting better so that the next time he's faced with a guy like that, he'll be prepared.
Well, this for sure is the best version of him we've ever seen from Sadio Akshan. Coming off of that, it's very disappointing.
Holy shit.
Sensing something was off on that swing. Looking like 8 feet to the cup here. Missing here. And this one is for the bogey. Oh my goodness, just missed. And this putt is for the double bogey. And that one will drop.
Really?
on to the 10th hole here. Is looking fairway bound.
Holy shit, smoked it. Check.
And for the par. And a nice putt there. And he's going to stay right where he is, even par after that one. This isn't looking too good. And setting up in the beach here.
Holy fuck.
Here's about 10 feet away. Ooh, just missing here. This one's about 8 feet. And that one will drop for the bogey. Moving on to the 12th. Here is the pitching wedge. Well, this one's still quite far away, but it is definitely on the green. Ooh, it just doesn't drop. And this putt's right around 2 feet. And after that hole, one over for the day.
Watch out.
And time for the 13th here.
Play for free and challenge friends. Go to ESPN.com/UFC Pick'em to make your picks now. All right, these locker room shots are brought to you by B3, the official protein snack of UFC. And it didn't take Ian Hine this long to crack the middleweight.
Oh, Lord.
He's experienced a valuable
run. Hang on.
Late, switched up his training camp.
Hang on.
That was too bad. He's ended up in the water here.
The guy who is candidly hungry to take his number, GM3, Gerald Burchard. He had 24 pro wins before even getting to the UFC. He appears primed to make a run. We will see if he can get a kickstart tonight with a win over Hine.
It didn't look like he had clean contact on that one. Well, at least this lie will be better than the last. They could have some work to do here. This one is setting up below the hole. And this putt to save par. Feet to accomplish. Yeah, plus one on the dunk after that hole.
Let's ride that wave. Let's ride that wave.
And I'm not quite sure here. It could end up in the fairway, though. Around a 9-footer.
Serious major wager alert for William Hill. A better has put a
billion. And that one drops for the birdie. And after that hole, that's going to bring him down to even par.
$5,000 and birthday Bogdanovich. He can't recall ever taking a 7-figure bet on the UFC prior to this. 7-figure bet, of course, on McGregor and Mayweather.
And now setting up for the par 4. Something seemed off with his swing on that. Now, let's see what can be done here with this lie. And he'll be happy with that. From 30 feet.
Drop it there.
Ooh, and just inches away. And for the par.
Oh my god.
Ooh, that was so close. It's about a few feet from the cup. And setting up on the 16th tee. Is not bound for the dance floor. Just too much club. And with this, hopefully, they can save par. Nice putt. And one over for the day after that hole. Okay, and moving on to the 17th now. With that shot from 145 yards out. Going with a pitching wedge here.
Come on back. Now go.
And now he's going to be digging that putter up. And this putt is for birdie.
You're working around the clock to get you more sharp. Stay safe.
Come on!
And that one will drop. And that hole will bring him down to even par. Whole action here. Let's see what happens. And I'm afraid he sliced this one. Okay, about 165 yards to the pin. Like a 7-iron. I don't think he really had a
clean
swing on that one. And missing the approach on that one. And it looks like the fade did not work in his favor on that one.
No relief?
Certainly a veteran.
43rd throat fight tonight. Support there from his teammate CM Punk. Here we go. Fight. This fight clock is brought to you by Modelo. I just threw trunks. First sharp absorbs the early inside leg kick. He's what?
And Mershart did not react well to that inside low kick.
It was a strong one. Heinisch opening up with two low kicks. You were talking about his training camp with this challenge.
Right.
You got to feel like that played a big part in this.
Yep. Tiger Muay Thai in Thailand after his previous few fights. We're trained at Factory X there in Colorado.
You got a lot of fighters trying that out. Going to Thailand, getting that old school Muay Thai from the motherland.
Right. Heinisch just felt like everything was centrally located and it's inexpensive. Feels like he has maybe found his future home for one.
And let's see what happens here from the same.
Everybody speaks about great, but the cost of being out in Thailand doesn't cost much.
Heinisch with a big right hand.
Well, Mershon covering up. Trying to get back to his feet.
Mershon's got to protect himself.
Oh,
he's invested.
Heinisch. Oh, the hurricane just went back. Heinisch with a shot. Heinisch with a knockout.
Ian Heinisch, you want to get back on the right track? That is how you do it. If you are Ian Heinisch, holy smoke, what a finish by the hurricane. Opening up with those big leg kicks. Gigantic.
Oh my goodness, that was close. And this next putt for a final round score of 74.
He went right at him and just right through
him. Hurricane Heinisch hit Las Vegas tonight. Now it's time.
Oh goodness, that was almost in. And this for the triple.
You saw those inside kicks and then look at that.
And finishing this one with a good putt.
Set up by Ian Heinisch. Very tricky, and it's not something you always catch when it's